Hi everyone, I'm Billy. In this video, we'll talk about sharpness. It's such a simple but abstract concept. Generally, it can be understood as the amount of pressure required to cut through an object cleanly. We'll take a closer look at a knife, give you some ideas on what makes a knife sharp, and how you can improve the sharpness of your knife. Let's get started. Why is sharpness important? When it comes to the kitchen, the significance of a sharp knife cannot be overstated for effective food preparation. A sharp knife plays a key role in minimizing cell damage by ensuring a cleaner and more precise cut. This means that fewer tissues are bruised and the oxidation occurs at a lower pace, resulting in ingredients staying fresh for a longer period of time. A research study published by the Korean Society of Food Preservation highlights this point, demonstrating that apples and lettuce cut with a sharp knife maintain their freshness for a longer duration compared to those cut with a dull knife. This reduced tissue damage is particularly important when working with delicate vegetables like spring onions and chives. A blunt knife can cause cell ruptures, resulting in a shorter shelf life and unappealing appearance. Apart from enhancing food quality, sharpness also plays a crucial role in ensuring personal safety. A sharp knife is less likely to slip off and more capable of cutting into food, reducing the risk of accidental cuts. In the long run, using sharp knives can help minimize occupational musculoskeletal disorders, as less effort is required to cut through ingredients as opposed to using excessive force. This is especially significant in large-scale operations. Sharpness is essential for maintaining the quality of the food and promoting the well-being of the knife user. How to test sharpness? Cutting tomato, paper, or shaving hair are some common tests for showing the sharpness of the bevel. The best sharpness test is a recent invention. It measures the sharpness of the edge according to the pressure needed to cut the wire. All of these methods give the knife user a better idea on the sharpness of their knife bevel. Using the paper test as an example, we can deduce whether the teeth profile on the knife is uniform or not.
這個就是那個重點,被人聽到什麼是不理。Okay.
A knife with a good bevel produces an audible sound cue like this. Yet, this method only gives you an idea on how sharp the edge is, because it only shows the bite of the edge on materials. It does not reflect on the overall sharpness of the knife. The first factor, bevel sharpness. The thin reflection line is the bevel, the cutting edge of a knife. Looking closer, you discover the knife is a saw. The serration on the knife helps cut into food. Therefore, it is generally recommended to incorporate push or pull motion into your cutting instead of vertical movements only. Rough stones will produce bigger teeth, and smaller teeth for smooth stones. The most improvement that people can make during sharpening is to polish the edge after it has been apexed. If you do not remove as much burr as possible on a stone, it will make you feel as if the edge dulls very quickly, which in fact is the burr acting as the cutting edge and bent to the side, burying the true cutting potential of the edge. Apply less and less pressure to remove the burr, like how a chef checks the meat for doneness. Feel the burr as you strop if you are not sure. Do not solely rely on rules or principles. Learn how to feel for yourself. Touch it with the smoothest part of your finger. Finally, strop to remove microscopic burr on the knife. You can use a leather strop, a towel, a denim cloth, or even newspaper to remove the tiny burr. As we can see from this microscopic view of the bevel, The sharpness of an edge can be harnessed only after all of its burr has been removed. The second factor, the edge geometry. The thinning, tapering, and geometry of a knife has much to do with its sharpness. The thicker the cross-section, the more cutting resistance it is going to face, as well as making food more likely to stick to the knife. Tomato tests demonstrate this point clearly, as only a thin enough knife can slice through it without moving the tomato. This is also what we tell our customers if they want a knife with good food releasing properties. As long as the knife is thin enough, the food will be less likely to stick to the knife. As demonstrated in this video, if a knife is sufficiently thinned, it can cut fairly easy, even with a dull edge. This goes to show the thickness of a knife has much to do with the sharpness. Using this sandoku as an example, you should lay the knife flat on a stone, follow the angle of the primary edge, and grind away a tiny bit every time you sharpen the cutting bevel. If you do not, the knife will get thicker and thicker every time you sharpen the cutting edge, resulting in a very, very blunt cutting sensation. This diagram shows the cross-section of a new knife. The knife is relatively thin and a bevel at a higher angle. Yet, the knife will become shorter and shorter every time you sharpen it, ending up with a thicker and thicker profile. To improve the sharpness of your knife, it is recommended to thin your knife bit by bit whenever you are sharpening your knife. The knife will slowly lose its overall sharpness, even if the edge is perfect. That's why we need to thin it in order to restore its sharpness. When you are trying to thin a thick knife, it would take an excruciating amount of time and effort, let alone doing it on a stone. It will be even worse if you are thinning extremely hard knife. Do be advised that it will scratch up the aesthetics of your knife in the long run. To thin a single bevel knife, you need to raise the shinogi line. When sharpening, lay it on the stone and apply pressure on the line. The marker line drawn on the knife denotes this shinogi line, which is the primary bevel of a Japanese single bevel knife. This further thins the knife for extra sharpness. Otherwise, the blade would get thicker and thicker if you only sharpens its cutting edge, losing its cutting performances. The same principle can be applied to any other Japanese single bevel knife, like a yanagiba, bocho, or deba. Besides requiring the necessary sharpening skills, it is also important to have a good sense of what you're doing. Does what you're cutting require a sharper knife or a stronger edge? A sharp knife is good for cutting vegetables or making fish slices. But you may also come across bones when cutting and actually want a thicker knife. By understanding and prioritizing sharpness, individuals can unlock the full potential of their knives for optimal results in the kitchen and beyond. We hope this video can give you new information on the idea of sharpness. What is your favorite knife? How do you sharpen it? Feel free to share with us in the comment section. Thank you for watching and take care.